afternoon, everyone. My topic is relationship between systemic hypertension, perfusion pressure, and glaucoma in North Indian patients. I have no financial interest. Glaucoma is the leading cause of blindness in India, accounting for 12.8% of the country's blindness, which affects approximately 12 million people. The vascular hypothesis of open-angle glaucoma states that a low blood pressure relative to a higher intraocular pressure may lead to a mean lower ocular perfusion, which may impair the perfusion of the optic nerve head. The overall prevalence of hypertension in India is 28.9%, and the prevalence of primary open-angle glaucoma is 20.4% in hypertensives. So the aim of the study was to study the relationship by comparing the prevalence of primary open-angle glaucoma in hypertensive and control group, studying the association between mean ocular perfusion pressure and glaucoma status as evident from mean deviation, average RNFL thickness in both groups, and studying and comparing the association between mean arterial pressure and intraocular pressure in both the groups. This was a prospective, observational, and comparative study. It was done between December 2015 and November 2016. The study population was undertaken at Venu Eye Hospital, New Delhi, and it comprised of 200 subjects divided into two groups of 100 each. So the inclusion criteria was patient age group 35 years and above, essential hypertension, either self-diagnosed or reported or newly diagnosed cases. Here we took the defining blood pressure as systolic blood pressure more than 140 and diastolic more than 90 mm of mercury. The exclusion criteria for both the groups, the participants who had hypertension due to secondary causes, either due to kidney disease or steroid use, etc., were excluded. Angle closure glaucoma was excluded. Secondary glaucoma was excluded. So methodology, detailed history was taken. We obtained a single measurement of BP, complete ocular examination including intraocular pressure by applanation tonometry, and gonioscopy was done. Mean arterial pressure was calculated by the formula, diastolic blood pressure plus one-third systolic minus diastolic blood pressure. Mean ocular perfusion pressure was obtained by two-third mean arterial pressure minus intraocular pressure. So OCT and visual field analysis was done in patients with high IOP, that is more than 21 mm of mercury, or cup disc ratio more than 0.5, or an asymmetry of more than 0.2. So the results, the mean age of the study group was 56.99 plus minus 12.22, and control group was 51.97 plus minus 12.22. There was a significant association between increasing age and presence of hypertension. Glaucoma was present in 33.5% of males, of which 56% had hypertension, 31% of females, of which 44% had hypertension. Hypertension was more prevalent in males. However, there was no relationship of gender with glaucoma. Glaucoma was present in 36.5% of the patients with hypertension and 28% in the control group. There was a statistically significant association between antihypertensive use and glaucoma. The relative risk was 1.388. However, the relationship of antihypertensive medication use with the severity of glaucoma was not found to be statistically significant. So this is a chart showing the mean ocular perfusion pressure. We see that in hypertensives, it is approximately 47.54, whereas in normotensives, it is lesser compared to 42.55. It is higher both as in mean arterial pressure is also higher and intraocular pressure is also higher in both groups. The chances of glaucoma significantly decreased by 3.61% with the increase of mean ocular perfusion pressure by one unit by calculating this Spearman's coefficient. When we calculated the correlation between mean arterial pressure and intraocular pressure in both the groups, we could obtain a correlation in the control group. However, we did not find any correlation between mean arterial pressure and intraocular pressure in the hypertensive group. So the discussion, the prevalence of open-angle glaucoma among hypertensives, 36.5%, is comparable to a study done by Deb et al. In South India, where the prevalence was noted to be 20.4%. In our study, prevalence of open-angle glaucoma between men and women was equal. It is similar to Baltimore, Beaver Dam, and Blue Mountain size study. But unlike Framingham and Barbados eye study and the Rotterdam eye study, where males were more prone for having glaucoma, there was a statistically significant association between antihypertensive use and glaucoma. A potential explanation may be related to the bedtime dosing. Also, altered autoregulation can also contribute. At night, there is an increase in IOP. So because of that, and the fall of blood pressure can cause this. We found a 3.61% reduction in rate of risk of having open-angle glaucoma. So the conclusion is the prevalence of glaucoma in hypertensive patients is higher. Mean ocular perfusion pressure in hypertensives are higher. More severe glaucoma is associated with lower mean ocular perfusion pressure. And we should screen systemic hypertension patients for glaucoma. These are my references. Thank you.
And this last slide in the conclusion, you said the mean OPP was higher in hypertensive patients.
Yes, sir.
Now, do you think it's protective or is it a negative
sir,
feature for this?
There are two theories. Some people say that it is protective because it will confer the higher perfusion pressure will confer a higher perfusion to the optic disc. But there is also the thing is that ki when, in general, when the blood pressure dips for all patients and intraocular pressure rises, so there will be a there is an autoregulatory mechanism. This mechanism is damaged in the hypertensives more. So this I could not.
No, actually the milieu of the eye inside the autoregulation is that of the higher arterial pressure, there is hypertension, the system is maintaining to maintain the ocular perfusion at its best with that high accentuated high blood pressure. But when you reduce it without taking care of the intraocular pressure, that will do the adverse effect. So all respect, if the patient is hypertensive, don't we should not try to do a drastic reduction of intraocular pressure unless we have taken the parallel measure to lower the intraocular pressure. Because sometimes we know that we get the pseudo glaucomatous disc changes when there is a history of acute blood loss in the puerperal period or Sheehan syndrome or something. You know the Sheehan syndrome and Simon syndrome. These are the same thing happens in the pituitary. All on a sudden reduction of blood pressure causes infarction. It may be the same thing is happening in the optic disc laminar area.
So in that way we should not be treating the glaucoma patient. I mean, once the patient is hypertensive and glaucoma also, according to your study, the ocular perfusion pressure is very good. This should be a protective mechanism rather than the.
Avoid the nighttime bed dosing, those things.
The lipid profile taken into account to exclude
no,
or.
Actually, if we talk to neurologists, it is a time-tested thing that patients who are likely to have stroke and all,
yes,
they don't decrease the blood pressure to beyond
much.
A particular level, like 140-90, they say it is a better rather
better
than,
than
bringing it to 120-80. And nocturnal blood pressure, again, is a very important thing, basically. So we are coming to this now, but the neurologists are already on.
That's true, but still, you see, this is, I mean, still very controversial and
yes, so
a very big dilemma. And this ultimately, the cardiologist has to ultimately decide okay, what maybe just can't do anything about. Our role is nothing but just to refer to the cardiologist. Please just take care of that in case he can.
Thank you.